When Zayed Khan said boys are best, he was backed up by actual science. Because findings show that when it comes to data collection, there's a huge gender bias. Which leads us to ask, are women fairly represented in data, or are the stats ghosting us? Toh chalo, baat ye jaan lo. What is gender bias in data? For years, medicine, healthcare, driving, and even urban planning have been designed keeping one default in mind, a white male weighing 70 kgs. By using this as the status quo, multiple communities, including people of color and other marginalized groups, have been left out of the discussion around product testing and safety. Journalist Caroline Criado Perez, in her book Invisible Women, highlights how women are AWOL in almost all the data gathered in every field, leading to a world built for men. There are countless cases of experiments, studies, and data collection where the end user is assumed to be male. Let's examine some of them. Aurat ko dard nahi hota. Like the uncle trying to sell you a top 3 sizes too small, healthcare has always had a one-size-fits-all approach. But men and women function differently, on a biological level. Even with concrete proof of this, women are excluded from critical medical research. Clinical trials evaluating the effect of aspirin on heart disease could have been called band of boys, because out of 22,000 patients, zero were women. Viagra was initially tested as a treatment for angina. It showed one minor side effect of causing an erection, and another as a cure for period pain. Guess what it's famous for today? No space for women. From police vests that don't account for boobs, fitness monitors that don't count housework, to crash test dummies that don't account for the female body, technology, from time immemorial to now, has put women in the backseat. One way urban planning. Gender can even affect one's journey to work. A survey revealed that while men generally follow a simple to and fro commute, women have complex routes home, involving many stops, not unlike their career paths. Even safety is gendered. There's a lack of infrastructural support for women in city planning. More data from women would help make cities more female friendly by including more pavements, footpaths, and streetlights. Beauty may lie in the eye of the beholder, but problems arise when that eye is always male. Gender bias in data has very real-world implications, like recalling more famous men than women, suggesting male candidates for political jobs, and associating more professions with men. The first step to solving the glaring sex and gender gap that persists across almost all fields is to always include more women in the decision-making. When more women are involved, there'll be better representation of what we need to survive equally in this world. Girls can also be best. Baat ye maan lo. Tell us what you think about gender bias in data in the comments below. And don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to Vitamins 3.